this is a computer UPS transformer. Now, these are thin wires for the high voltage, and these are two thick low voltage wires. Now, out of these four, I have to choose only two wires with the help of resistance checking through this multimeter. So let's point it to the resistance checking mode. First, take green as common and keep changing the other wires. Here we have 4.9 ohms, 6.5 ohms, way too less. Green and black, 20.5 ohms, that's very high. So none of these. Now taking black as common and then yellow, 19.3 ohms, very high. Blue, 17.6, and green, around 21 ohms. So blue is, I think, what we need here. It is 17.7 ohms. So let's test the output for black and blue input combination. These two have to be tested. Now, setting the multimeter to AC voltage measurement mode, that is DC, F3, and we have AC connecting red to red and black to blue. Well, let's first show you the line voltage. Here we have 235 volts AC. Now, let's turn it off and reconnect it as it was before. Time to connect these two wires to the 220 volts point. Turning it on and go. Now, this single transformer is capable of producing up to 100 amperes or more, and because of this, it can easily handle heavy loads. Here, as you can see, that I have six transformers connected to each other with the help of zip ties. You see, all zip tied together. And I used this set in one of my previous projects where I made an induction heater. So this is the primary side for all the transformers. And you can see that I have zip tied the green ones, the yellow ones, for all the transformers. Now, all that we have left are the blue wires and the black wires. So let's strip them. Yeah, so all have been stripped. Time to connect all of them together. So here I'm planning on making three sets out of this pack, and each set will contain two transformers in total. I understand that I should be using a little thicker wires for the primary side or the high voltage side, because I'm going to use these transformers for welding and the current that is going to be drawn is going to be very high. But this is just a temporary project for experimentation. So go for 2.5 square mm wires or more than that. After completing the taping and the zip tying process, time to move on to the high current secondary. Here, as you can see, there are 12 wires in total, two for each transformer, and each denoted by its own color, which is red and blue. Now, this color is very important because it is going to separate the wiring process. Now, after completing the stripping part, let's move on to the wiring of the secondary. These two will make the first set, these two will make the second set, and these two will make the third set. So take the two blue wires of the first set and connect them together with the two red wires of the set below. See? Now, same as before, I'm going to use these iron wires used in construction to join them together. Moving on to the next part, which are these two blue wires left out of the second set and these two red wires from the lowest set. These will be connected together again. Finally, we are left with two blue wires from the lowest set and two red wires from the first set at the top. So connecting these two together, and same for these two. And we are done. So by connecting the wires like this, I've connected the first two transformers together in parallel, same parallel for the next two transformers, and parallel for the last two transformers. And at the same time, I've connected the first set in series with the second, and the second in series with the third. And the overall output will appear on the first and the last set wires. Now let's connect the input wires to the home socket supply and hear the humming sound. Turning it on.
So let's connect the meter pin outs to measure the overall output voltage. Turning it on. And we have here around 28 volts AC. Now here I have this 1 kilowatts 220 volts high speed washing machine motor that I'm going to test with my huge transformer setup. Turning it on, holding it from the top because there is going to be jerk, and finally touching this wire. Okay, I cannot believe that it is unable to start even at 27 volts AC. Now here as you can see that I have this 12 volts UPS battery, and here with the help of DC source it is going to start. You see? So this is a difference that I just learned. I knew it before that there is going to be a huge difference, but this much, this was not expected. Time to connect the welding cable as shown. Now let's use this iron wire again to connect this top red wire to this welding cable. So the red wire has finally been connected. Moving on to the other one. So the final welding cable has also been connected. Time to do the test.